Elon Musk looks like he wants to quit. Tesla's Elon Musk says he is thinking of quitting his jobs. Wow. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel. Look at this. Tesla's chief executive officer, Elon Musk, is thinking of leaving his jobs and becoming an influencer. The world's richest man tweeted on Thursday, thinking of quitting my jobs and becoming an influencer full time. What do you think? Musk said in a tweet without elaborating. So, what do you think about this? What do you think Musk means? Is he serious? It was not immediately clear, Reuters report, if Musk, a prolific user of social media platform, was being serious about quitting his roles. Would you like Elon Musk to quit his roles? Musk, who is also the founder and CEO of rocket company SpaceX and leads brain chip startup Neuralink, which I'm not in very much favor of because I don't like chips in humans. This is not fine in my opinion. And infrastructure firm The Boring Company, is also the CEO of that, said during a conference call in January that he expects to be the CEO of Tesla for quote-unquote several years. Well, it would be nice to have a bit more free time on my hands as opposed to just working day and night from when I wake up to when I go to sleep at 7 days a week. That's pretty intense, Elon Musk said. Last month, he asked his followers on Twitter whether he should sell 10% of his stake in the electric car maker, to which the majority agreed. He has sold shares worth nearly $12 billion since. Well, friends, let me know, what do you think? Elon Musk, if he becomes an influencer, what type of values will he influence for? Electric transition or other moral great values? I don't know. And would you like Elon Musk to quit? What are your thoughts on this? Let me know your thoughts. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news. Let's continue the discussion in the comments section below, and I look forward to reading your comments. Have a wonderful day. Peace be with all of you. God bless you, everyone. And let's move on to our next Tesla story. Jörg Steinbach today just said that Tesla's waiver of subsidies to build a 4680 battery factory at the Giga Berlin was a weighing of interest. According to Brandenburg's economics minister Jörg Steinbach, Tesla had voluntarily waived government funding of billions for the planned battery production in Grünheide near Berlin. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla news. Steinbach said on Wednesday, December 8, 2021, in the Economic Committee of the State Parliament, that the U.S. electric car maker Tesla attaches importance to the fact that no negotiations with the federal government have failed. Quote, it was a weighing of interests. In the end, where does Tesla see the greatest advantage for itself? In the short-term use of state aid on in the long-term use of its own know-how, said Steinbach. The weighing of interest was influenced by the company's economic situation. It is also not the case that Tesla does not want to submit to certain rules of the game. That gets the wrong touch, emphasized the minister. New types of batteries are to be manufactured on the site at Giga Berlin of the car factory Tesla in Berlin. Those are the 4680 new Tesla batteries that are going to be more dense, more energy efficient, and give more mileage to Tesla vehicles. At the end of November, Tesla informed the Federal Ministry of Economics and the Brandenburg Ministry of Economics that it no longer wanted to participate in the second major European project for battery cell production. It's called EU BatIn. Therefore, the application for state funding for the IPCEI, Transnational Project for Common European Interest, for the battery factory in Grünheide, Giga Berlin, has been withdrawn. And as I reported yesterday, Peter Altmaier, the outgoing economy minister of Germany, also said something similar, that Tesla did not want to wait until the decision on battery subsidies was made in Germany and EU and withdrawn. And today, Jörg Steinbach, a Tesla supporter, says that Tesla had voluntarily waived government funding of billions for the planned battery production in Grünheide in Giga Berlin, and it was a weighing of interest. Welcome back, friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel and let me know your thoughts. Do you think Tesla did the right thing when refusing subsidies so it can produce more batteries elsewhere as well to meet its needs? I think Tesla did the right thing in my opinion, and I would probably do the same thing, especially if you have the cash to do that. Otherwise, why tie your hands and also only do the innovation in Giga Berlin and not be able to build batteries elsewhere that desperately need for your cars? Please subscribe to our channel and let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you. And let's move on to our next Tesla. Mercedes story. Beats Tesla to hands-free driving on highways. Decision by government and authorities in Germany paves the way for the Mercedes to offer the level 3 system globally. Look at this, friends. Daimler's Mercedes-Benz won regulatory approval to deploy a hands-free driving system in Germany ahead of Tesla, gaining an edge in the race to offer higher level of automation in one of the world's most competitive car markets, Germany. The automaker got to go ahead to sell its Drive Pilot package for use on stretches of the country's Autobahn network at a speed of up to 60 kilometers per hour. That's a speed of up to 37 miles per hour. So Mercedes in Germany gets level 3 autonomy on up to 37 miles per hour. The system was approved for level 3 autonomous driving, a notch higher than Tesla's level 2 autopilot system, and will allow a driver to take their hands off the wheel in slow-moving traffic. Okay, so Drive Pilot enables the driver to turn away from the traffic and focus on certain secondary activities, Mercedes said in a statement on Thursday. For example, to communicate with colleagues via the in-car office, to write emails, to surf the internet, or to relax and watch a film, the statement said. But keep in mind, up to 37 miles per hour. Tesla's Alphabet's Waymo and others have been chasing self-driving technology for years. A fully autonomous vehicle would be highly attractive to premium customers, allowing drivers to work or use entertainment systems while on journey. Mercedes got permission for the system only in Germany, but said it is aiming for regulatory approval in other jurisdictions as well. As soon as legislation in China and the United States is in place, Mercedes-Benz will offer the system in those markets as well, said Markus Schäfer, Daimler Chief Technology Officer. Drive Pilot. Have you ever heard of this? I honestly had not. So Drive Pilot will be on an option for the S-Class Mercedes and EQS electric models from around the middle of next year. So this is a coming technology, but already has level 3. The automaker has not decided how much it will charge for the system, which has approval to be used on around 13,000 kilometers of Germany's highway network. Tesla has run into trouble in Germany with its driver assistance technology after a German court rebuffed the company's promotion of autopilot last year, saying the automaker has misled consumers about what the system can do. CEO of Tesla, Elon Musk, has long offered optimistic views on the capabilities of this car, even going so far as to start charging customers thousands of dollars for a full self-driving future in 2016. Years later, Tesla still requires users of its autopilot system to be fully attentive and ready to take over driving at any time, because while it may have level 3 capabilities, but it's still officially level 2. Mercedes is not the first automaker to market level 3 technology in a production car. Honda Motors in 2020 received approval approval from Japanese regulators for such a system in its Legend model, although only deployed in a limited production run. Torque News has covered that. If you search Honda Legend Torque News Level 3, you will probably find that report. Germany's KBA authority approved the system based on technical requirements laid out in United Nations regulations. The KBA is setting national, European, and international standards in road safety on the road to autonomous driving, said the authority's president Richard Dunn. Beyond the United States, United Nations regulation on technical requirements, countries also have to pass legislation clarifying where and how such systems can be used, as well as issues of liability. So, you know, the autonomous driving, it has five levels approved by the United Nations. Level 5 is where there is no steering wheel, but right now looks like Mercedes is getting ahead of the Tesla with getting level 3 driving of level 3 system globally and up to 37 miles per hour, and can deploy this technology in any places where, I mean, technology is called Drive Pilot by Mercedes, where the regulations allow. So as soon as the United States allows that regulation in the United States, Mercedes will bring it in S-Class and EQS electric vehicle, the Drive Pilot, to the United States. Well, friends, let me know what you think about this. I think this is very interesting. This is Armin Harayan from TorqueNews.com. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section below, and have a wonderful day. Please subscribe to this channel for daily electric vehicle Tesla breaking interesting discussions, and God bless you, everyone. Peace be with all of you, and let's move on to our next story.